Hey kids, today we're making gingerbread cupcakes with gingerbread buttercream frosting.
It's YouTube's best for creative things. It's cooking and crafting.
Hey kids. Last year when I went to Amsterdam, I got just a couple of things, and one of them was these cupcake baking cups. Every time I see this, I always think I see vampires, but I couldn't resist because they were just too delightful for words. And I have been struggling trying to find something to make, and I finally decided, since there were so many things that were cinnamon related when I went to that kind of like an open market type of thing. There were so many cinnamon things, I decided let's try to do something cinnamon, and that would be fitting for these cupcakes. With that, let's get started. I have 5 tablespoons of salted butter at room temperature, and I am going to be adding in 1/2 cup of extra fine granulated sugar. I didn't have extra fine granulated sugar, and you know I'm all about using what you have. So what I did was I put the sugar into my food processor and I ground it down to a nice finer sense instead of, you know, that regular granulated sugar. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put it on anywhere between low to medium speed until this is light and fluffy, about 3 minutes. As that's going, I am going to add in 1/2 cup of molasses, as well as 1 egg and 1 egg yolk. And I'm going to let that continue to combine. When that's done, I'm going to scrape down the sides of this pan, making sure that everything gets in combined nicely. I'll make sure the rest of that gets in there. And here's my egg and my egg yolk. Just a note, when you take off the bowl from your mixer, make sure you put it on correctly, or it makes a ka-ching, ka-ching, ka-ching noise. Right here is 1 1/4 cup of all-purpose flour. In this nice bowl here, I have 1 tablespoon of unsweetened cocoa powder, 1 teaspoon of ground ginger, 1 teaspoon of ground cinnamon that I picked up in Amsterdam, 1/2 teaspoon of ground nutmeg, and 1 teaspoon of baking soda. I'm just gonna make sure that that is nicely combined. And what we're going to do is alternating this with 1/2 cup of buttermilk. We are going to add that to this butter mixture here. And I am going to start with the on slow. And I should have my top here that allows me to put my flour in, but this is easy enough. I'm going to add that in. Once it's combined, I will go ahead and add in a part of the buttermilk until it's all combined. We'll be back. Make sure in the middle of all this that you go ahead and scrape down the sides of your bowl. Now I'm just going to go ahead and I'm going to use my scoop here, and we're going to put this into a preheated 350 degree oven, making sure, the boop! making sure that the cups are only filled to about 2/3 full. This is a nice, mix, very nice. And it smells awesome. So once it goes into that oven, it is going to bake for 20 minutes. This should make 12 cupcakes. But it looks like, it looks like it will. See you in 20 minutes. Go a little less than 2/3, as these completely came out of the cupcake liners. This is not going to be fun. I have the cupcakes cooking. cooling. They should be done soon. I put my whisk attachment on, and I have 1 cup or 2 sticks of unsalted butter at room temperature, which I am going to put on medium to high speed, and we are going to beat this
for 5 minutes, making sure to stop at least once to scrape the side of the bowl. All right, with the 5 minutes done, what I have here is 1/4 cup of molasses again, and I have 1 teaspoon of ground cinnamon, 1/2 teaspoon of ground ginger, and 1/2 teaspoon of ground nutmeg. And I'm going to be putting the speed back down to low, and I am going to add the molasses in slowly, and then also the spices. And we're just gonna beat this on low speed until it's incorporated before we add in the last, which would be 3 cups of confectioner or powdered or baking sugar. Okay, I scraped down my bowl, and now I'm gonna add in my spices, and I will have to scrape down the bowl once again just to make sure that all of that that's caught there on the side gets incorporated as well. All right, I'm gonna start to incorporate my powder, but I'm gonna do it a little at a time, making sure that each time it's incorporated before I add any more. So I'll put about 3/4 of a cup in there. And I'm gonna continue on until I have it all in there, and then we're gonna turn the heat up a bit. Okay, so it is mostly incorporated, so I'm going to stop this now. And I'm gonna make sure that all the crazy powder that hasn't been added in, and get to scrape this down. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to put my speed up to medium high, and we're going to beat this until it's nice and fluffy. Well, approximately 2 minutes. There we go. Hang on, Gangi. And the 2 minutes is up. Now, it's always very warm and humid here in Hawaii, so buttercreams don't normally stand up the way they would anywhere else, because the butter just gets out of control melted. Plus, it doesn't help that it's under these lights so that you can actually see what I'm doing. So if you need to add more powdered sugar, you can probably go ahead and do so. I'm going to probably add in just the tiniest bit, not too much. I'll see how it goes frosting one of those. I don't think it'll stand up at all. But there you go. That's your gingerbread buttercream frosting portion of this. And so now you can just go ahead and pipe the frosting onto your cupcakes. I went ahead and tried these. They're awesome. I love gingerbread, however, so these are so good. It's not even funny. Meanwhile, I put my frosting into my bag, and I had it sitting in this decorating bag holder that I received from my friends at Yoli. The wonderful thing about this is it's got two of these huge, Sam, two huge spots here, as well as smaller ones. So if you're going to be decorating with different colors, you have enough space for all of that. And then they also have these little tiny ones for those people that do the really special cake decorating to hold the flower nails and stuff. Amazing. I thank you so much, Yoli, for sending that to me. Thank you. I'll place a link down in the description box so that you can see it as well. And I'm just gonna do my standard piping on this. It's just not going to be anything special, because we're just going to grub these like nobody's business. When they were baking, Mom says, "Oh my gosh, it's been so long since I've had gingerbread." Yep, it sure certainly has. So just going to put a little on it. I don't want to make it too ungodly sweet. So there you go, folks. Gingerbread cupcakes with gingerbread buttercream frosting. Enjoy.
Thank you for watching Cooking and Crafting. Before we goodbye. Make sure you comment and subscribe. And it would be so great if you favorite and rate. Thanks for